In this video, I am going to discuss about a SAS procedure known as PROC KDE. So KDE stands for the coronal density estimation. Now the purpose of this procedure is to perform univariate and multivariate estimation or density estimation. So what is kernel density estimation? Kernel density estimation is a technique which is used for density estimation in which a known density function which is also known as a kernel is averaged across the data to create an approximation. So it is very similar to the way we plot a histogram. Just that more sophisticated technique is being used in this case. So let us take an example and understand how we can use PROC KDE to do some basic visualization of the data and understand the pattern in the data, the dynamics in the data. So I'll take a simulated data. So this is the two variables here, x and y, both are normally distributed, and then this is all, there is also bivariate normality here in the sense that the joint distribution of x and y are also is also normal. So create a simulated data with the simulation. I have used the RANNOR function to create these simulated data for me. When I run this code, I'll get this data set by var. So I've got x and y, you can see, and both x and y are close to normal distribution, and the joint distribution is also normal distribution. Now let me first see how we can use PROC KDE to conform to the fact that the data follows normal distribution. So the syntax is like this: PROC KDE data and then input data set by var. So I'm going to plot the variable x first and see whether it's normal distributed. So when I run this, okay, if you go to the result window, you will get this one. Now this looks perfectly normally distributed. If you have a data, this is simulated data, we already know that this is normally distributed. Well, there will be data sets which coming from the real world. The real world data will not be normally distributed most of the times. So we can actually verify whether your data is normally distributed or not by plotting a kernel density. The kernel density actually non-parametrically comes off with a probability density, which may not be normal density all the time. It will be different. It will be completely non-parametric, so it may not fall under the category of any conventional density. That we know, like normal density or any other densities. Now, more uses of PROC KDE. We can also plot the bivariate contour and the surface plot. So, how do we do that? We use the ODS graphics so that we can get the graphs, PROC KDE data, input data set. We use the keyword bivar here, and both these variables are input variables are used, x and y. And we use the plots option and provide contour and surface as the parameters. Now, when we run this code, if you go to the result window, you will see the contour plot. Well, contour plot is just a cross cross section of your three-dimensional plot. It's a better visualization of how your data really look like. So you can get a contour plot like this using PROC KDE. You can also get a surface plot, which is a three-dimensional plot, And you can see the bivariate distribution is also normal, as it looks normal. You can actually do a lot more variation of this by changing some certain parameters, but this is just a basic use of PROC-KDE. Then the last thing that we will see is when you actually do everything together, you do the univariate plot, the you know, density overlay, and you compare the density plots for x and y, every single thing together. So we use the syntax univariX, and we'll plot density histogram and hist density. That means both histogram and density at the same time or on the same plot. And then we'll also see the univariate density or the kernel density for x and y on the same you know, plot or same graph. So we can compare how the densities vary, right? So all these things we'll do in a single piece of code. Okay, now you can see we have the distribution of x, which is the histogram. Now in the second plot we have got the kernel density. Earlier we have seen that they were on the same graph, but now we have separated them out. The final thing is an overlay. The kernel density is along with the histogram, and the fourth plot is showing the comparison between the kernel densities of x and y. So you know, we can see how the distribution vary, you know, for this. So they deviate from normality to some extent, you know, and the kurtosis and skewness is also different for these two, you know, two continuous variables. So that's how we use the PROC-KDE, you know, to visualize data and see the distribution. If you want the code, write to us. Our contact details, you can find it, analyticsuniversity@gmail.com. You can find that in the description as well.